Hello, I'm Nikias Klohr, head of R&D here at RaceResult, and today I would like to talk about the accuracy of the internal clock of our active timing system. As you might know, the accuracy of the internal clock is quite important. It is the base of all recorded times, and this means it's also the base of what you do. If you're looking at the clock, there are two things which are important. One thing is that the accuracy should have no deviation from one device to the other. This means that if you replace one of the devices, it should make no difference. And the second point is that the clock should have no drift over time and temperature. This means that if you set up a race where you have one timing device at the start and one at the finish, it should not give anyone an advantage to start at the beginning of the day or the end of the day. If you're looking at those two points, we do two things. One thing is that we are using a very precise clock. We are using a TCXO. This means it's a temperature compensated crystal oscillator. This gives us an accuracy of 0.28 ppm. This means that we get a maximum drift of 2.4 hundredths of a second per day under worst case condition in the complete temperature range. And as a second step, we hand tune the TCXO in our final production process. This needs to be done because the TCXO itself is very stable, but the soldering process and production gives you deviations from one device to the other. So here you see our frequency counter that we use to calibrate the TCXO on our active system. And up here you see our rubidium frequency standard. What's important is that the frequency counter itself already has a very precise clock, but to be sure that this clock is running correctly, we calibrate it against our rubidium frequency standard before every measurement and after every measurement. The frequency standard itself, again, is calibrated, traceable to the National Institute for Standard and Technology. So we are counting the 10 MHz output signal of the rubidium frequency with our frequency counter against its internal clock. This gives us a double safety net that our clock is really precise and that the units we ship are within spec. If we compare the 10 MHz signal to the internal clock, we expect a readout very close to 10 MHz. If you do the math, you will find out that for a 10 MHz signal, 1 ppm, 1 part per million, is 10 Hz. So this figure here has to be within spec. Actually, with this setup, we see that those two clocks agree within 0.1 ppm, 0.0.1 ppm. So this means we have a lot of safety margin for our 0.28 ppm that we are guaranteeing for our active system. And to make sure it is precise, we need to hand-tune every single unit as a final production step. So I will present you how we do that. We connect the module to a frequency counter. You see up here, this frequency counter is referenced to a rubidium frequency normal. And we fine trim this to 6.400000 MHz. And this gives us a repeatable accuracy of 0.28 ppm.